Hi, I'm Chris Peterson from Chelan County PUD, and I work with customers who need power extended to their property when an existing power source isn't available nearby. If you need a line extension, you'll either work with me or someone like me here at the PUD. Line extensions have a lot of moving parts. They typically take 3 to 4 months to complete. Our priority throughout this process is to bring you reliable electric service and to make sure it's done safely. To get started, give us a call or visit our website. We'll ask you for details about your project, such as parcel number, size of service, and the voltage. We'll need to see a site plan, and we'll ask you to pay an application fee. Once a customer service engineer reviews your plan and completes a design, you'll receive a letter outlining costs and explaining payment options. If an easement is necessary, you'll receive easement papers that must be signed and notarized. There are 2 types of line extensions, overhead and underground. All work associated with an overhead line extension must be completed by the PUD. For underground line extensions, private contractors can do some of the trenching, and the PUD will complete the actual connection of electrical equipment. At any time during this process, a PUD representative will be happy to meet with you on site to go over the requirements and help you successfully complete your project. If you'll be completing the earthwork for an underground extension, there are some materials that you will need to purchase, such as conduit and ground rods, and pick up other materials supplied by the PUD from one of our warehouses, such as transformer vaults, fiber handholds, or sleeves. Of course, for your safety and the safety of others, be sure to call 811 before digging any trenches. Install warning tape in the trench 12 inches below the finished grade. The PUD provides this tape. And do not attempt to access any existing PUD electrical equipment without a PUD representative on site. After your conduit, vaults, and equipment are installed and grounded, call our trench inspector for approval. All customer-installed equipment must be approved by the PUD's inspector prior to backfilling. At this point, we'll check to see that your line extension has been paid, all easements have been signed and notarized, and that all the earthwork has been approved by our inspector. If all systems are go, we'll schedule your project and provide you with an estimate of when the PUD crews can be on site to complete the work of installing power to your property. The PUD generally can have a construction crew on site within 3 to 4 weeks after scheduling. Because our schedule is often affected by outages, weather, and unforeseen circumstances, exact dates are very difficult to provide. All of this information is covered in our new line extension brochure. Of course, you can always talk to me or another customer service engineer in our office about your project. And just one more thing, as a reminder, a line extension brings primary electrical power closer to your home. You won't actually receive electrical service until your secondary is installed. This is the connection between the transformer and your home. But no worries, your secondary service may be able to be installed at the same time. That part's covered in our new electrical secondary service information pamphlet. We'll help you through that process too, getting you reliable Chelan County power connected quickly and safely.